This is an excerpt from my free online mini course, The 7 Steps for Making It as a Mural Artist. If you want to view all 7 steps in the one place, then sign up for the course for free via this link. Welcome to step 3 of my mini course, The 7 Essential Steps to Making It as a Mural Artist. My name's Fieldy and I'm a professional muralist, and this step is super fun. It's where you get to dream up exactly what you want to paint on your wall. If you want to know more about this topic or explore, you know, some more in-depth online courses about this, then check out my online academy. Your concept is a scale representation of what you're intending to paint on the client's wall. It can be entirely hand-drawn or sketched, or created digitally and overlaid over the photo you took of the wall in step 1. You need to give your client a good representation of what you're intending to paint on the wall for 2 main reasons. 1, so you know what's going to go on the wall, and you can use your concept to scale the outlines up big on the wall. And number 2, so your client knows what's going to go on the wall and has a chance to make any changes or amends to the design until they're happy with it. After you finish the concept to the client's satisfaction, but before you start painting, I recommend getting written approval to proceed from your client in writing. This could simply be an email that just basically says, I am happy with this concept and give my approval for painting to begin. This is a kind of insurance measure for you. So if your client says they don't like any part of the finished artwork, as long as it was in the original concept and looks similar, then you can point them back to the concept and, you know, that they approved, and then explain that, you know, you'd be very happy to make those changes, but you're gonna have to charge extra for your time to do this as it's outside of the scope of the original project. So the concept that you have is gonna be your proof of this. So you're gonna take those measurements that you wrote down in step 1, and you're gonna create a manageable scale version of it. So for instance, and you know, I'm sorry, everybody in the US, I'm gonna be using metric here, but if the wall is 2 meters wide by 1.5 meters high, I'm gonna create a concept that's like 1/10 of the size. So it's 20 centimeters by 15 centimeters high. So check back at your site visit notes and look at your photos to see where the windows and doors are and any other things you need to design around. Start off by brainstorming your ideas and drawing some rough sketches for what you have in mind. I'd recommend that if your wall is in a super sunny spot, then you should avoid the types of colors which will be certain to fade quickly. So limit adding them to your concept. When you're happy with your idea, it's time to create the concept that you'll show to the client. There are loads of ways that you can create a concept, but the easiest is on a piece of paper, which is like ruled up to your scale wall dimensions. You can use anything you like to draw up the concept and color it, but I'd recommend trying to keep it looking as close as possible to how the finished artwork will appear. So, you know, this can be a little bit of a balancing act, as you also don't want to spend a week creating a concept, but you also want your client to be able to see how it will look on their wall. So, you know, there's no nasty surprises at the end of the project if they're like, well, wow, that's not what I signed off. Personally, I like to create digital concepts so I can quickly and easily edit them and experiment with colors and composition. So to do this, I like to use an iPad Pro and an Apple Pencil and create the concepts in Procreate, which allows me to use different paintbrush styles and incorporate my reference photos into the design. You know, if you don't have an iPad and things like that, you could also use Adobe Photoshop, Illustrator, or a free online photo editor. One thing to note is if you're going to use photos as reference material to paint your mural from, it's a good idea to stay clear of copyright material, which is like generally what most photos on the internet are. So unless you purchase them from a stock photo company or use free ones that have been designated with a Creative Commons license. You know, obviously you can also use your own photos, or you could also ask permission to use the photos from a photographer that you like. Once you've created your concept, email it or show it to your client in person, and if they like it, make sure they give you the written approval to proceed to painting. And if they have changes, then you'll go ahead and make those changes and resubmit the concept, and you do this until the client is happy with it. Once the concept has been approved, it's time to prepare the wall before you start painting it. If you want to know more or explore this topic in depth, then join up to Fieldy's Art Academy All Access membership for only $49 a month and get access to all of my courses, plus monthly group coaching sessions with me, where you can ask questions, update your progress, and even receive art critiques in a supportive, friendly environment. This is a massive saving, and it's really going to help you turbocharge your art career and help set it up right. I'll be adding new videos on a regular basis, so there will always be something new for you to learn on your art journey.